Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India.
Good evening, welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Chonsom. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Monday, the 15th of March. Top Jaish commander neutralized in encounter in India's Jammu and Kashmir. Pakistan People's Party set to challenge rejection of votes in Senate poll. And Sri Lanka to ban burqas and shut Islamic schools for national security. And now for all the details. Top commander of Pakistan-based Jaish-e Mohammed outfit, Sajjad Afghani, was killed by security forces in a three-day-long gunfight in Shopian district of India's Jammu and Kashmir on Monday. Sajjad Afghani had been involved in the recruitment of youth into terrorism. According to local police, a total of two terrorists have been killed in the operation that started over the past weekend and was still underway till the last reports came in. India has long accused Pakistan of training and helping terrorists infiltrate across the border and mount attacks on its soil. The Shopian encounter comes at a time when the two nuclear-armed neighbors have recently agreed to end exchange of fire along their de facto border, which had come as a big relief to those worried that the ongoing tension could escalate in near future. The Union Forum of Bank Union, an umbrella body of nine bank unions, has called for a two-day nationwide strike on Monday and Tuesday against the privatization of public sector banks and retrograde banking reforms. Over 1 million bank employees and officers are participating in the strike.
Nine bank unions in India on Monday began a nationwide two-day strike against the privatization of public sector banks and retrograde banking reforms. With banners and posters, bank employees in capital New Delhi, Western Vadodara, Southern Vijayawada and several other cities raised slogans as they took to the streets to protest the government's decision. Workers are opposing the privatization move as it could put their jobs at risk. Services such as deposits and withdrawal at branches, check clearance and loan approvals are getting affected due to the strike, as most of the junior level staff are participating in the strike.
This privatization will affect not only to our staff but also to the general public. There will be increase in the service charges. The public has to pay minimum balance of rupees 10,000 in saving bank, 25,000 in current account. There will be the job, no recruitment in private sector.
The bank strike comes after Indian Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman had announced the privatization of two public sector banks as part of the government's disinvestment plan. As part of the 2021 Union Budget, the government has already privatized IDBI Bank by selling its majority stake in the lender to LIC in 2019. It will soon take a call on the two banks and one general insurer that will be taken up for privatization in the next fiscal year.
In a first, the four leaders of the Quad, a strategic forum comprising India, Japan, Australia and the United States, reaffirmed their commitment to a free and open Indo-Pacific in a joint op-ed in the Washington Post. In Friday's Quad meeting, the leaders vowed to strive for an Indo-Pacific region that is free, open, inclusive, healthy, anchored by democratic values and unconstrained by coercion, sending an apparent message to China. Post the Quad summit, Indian envoy Taranjit Singh Sindhu said India-US relationship is going much deeper, and this was very much reflected in the equation between Prime Minister Modi and President Biden.
Indian Ambassador to the United States Taranjit Singh Sandhu on Monday said that the relations between New Delhi and Washington is going much deeper, and this was very much reflected in the equation between Prime Minister Narendra Modi and President Joe Biden. Friday's power-packed virtual meeting between the heads of government from Quadrilateral Security Dialogue or Quad, a strategic forum comprising India, Japan, Australia and the United States of America, has firmly set a democratic diamond around China. And even though China was not named during the 90-minute-long summit, the joint statement followed by the strongly worded opinion article in the Washington Post has clearly underscored that Quad countries will be unrestrained from coercion.
The general atmosphere was very good amongst all the leaders. And as you know, that United States-India relationship is gone much deeper. And this was very much reflected in the equation between Prime Minister Modi and President Biden.
The summit was Biden's first multilateral leaders' meeting since taking office, with the first 60 days of his administration, something that National Security Advisor Jake Sullivan said was deliberate. Meanwhile, New Delhi is expected to discuss steps to take in the Quad initiative further when U.S. Secretary of Defense Lloyd Austin visits India after the stops in Tokyo and Seoul.
In news from Pakistan, the opposition Pakistan People's Party has announced it will approach the Islamabad High Court against the rejection of votes in the Senate chairman election held last week. This comes as the opposition joint candidate Syed Yusuf Raza Gilani was defeated in the crucial poll by just 7 votes.
Pakistan People's Party has constituted a 4-member team of its legal experts to draft a petition to be filed at the Islamabad High Court against the rejection of votes in the Senate chairman election. The party is expected to file the petition on Tuesday or Wednesday, according to the local media reports. This comes at a time when opposition alliance, the Pakistan Democratic Movement, which includes Pakistan People's Party, is mulling over options to seek a legal remedy to their defeat in the Senate chairman election when its joint candidate, Syed Yusuf Raza Gilani, lost to the ruling PTI's packed Sadiq Sajrani by 7 votes. The opposition has challenged the election result after it was announced, saying that the 7 votes cast in favour of Gilani had been rejected. The presiding officer, however, overruled the objection, saying the votes were rejected because they were stamped improperly.
Moving on, activists and locals have strongly condemned the recent resolution seeking interim provincial status for Gilgit-Baltistan by the Legislative Assembly, where Pakistan's ruling PTI has a majority. They have expressed concern that altering the illegally occupied region's status will instead give a free hand to Pakistan to plunder resources and further exploit the already marginalized people.
Just after nearly 4 months of coming to power in Gilgit-Baltistan through an allegedly rigged election, Pakistan PM Imran Khan-led Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf Party is now planning to seek provincial status for the illegally occupied region. The Gilgit-Baltistan Legislative Assembly passed a resolution last week demanding that Imran Khan and Pakistan's state institutions grant the region interim provincial status. The move has been strongly criticized by locals as well as activists who say that altering Gilgit-Baltistan's status will do no better to the region, but will instead give a free hand to Pakistan to plunder their resources.
यहाँ के आवाम को बेवकूफ बना के चंद खुशामदियों को अपने साथ मिला के यहाँ के वसाइल पर कंट्रोल करने और अपने आइनी दफात को जो हम आइन का हिस्सा नहीं हैं उनको यहाँ ला के मुसलत करके हमारे साथ जुल्म जबर करने के अलावा और कुछ नहीं है।
गिलगित-बल्तिस्तान मसला कश्मीर का हिस्सा है और गिलगित-बल्तिस्तान एक मुतनाज़ा इलाका है और अगर पाकिस्तान इस किस्म की कोई हरकत करता है क्योंकि ये खासे बेवकूफ़ हैं और ये दुनिया के सामने अपनी खिफत मिटाने के लिए अपनी शर्मिंदगी को मिटाने के लिए जो है ना ये इस किस्म की हरकतें करते रहते हैं तो ये बिल्कुल गलत है और इसके ऊपर जो है वो एक्शन होना चाहिए.
Activists have blamed the move is to appease Pakistan's all-weather friend China, which has been lobbying it to gain complete political control over the illegally occupied region for its ambitious China-Pakistan economic corridor. Activists have raised concern it would mean that Pakistan-China nexus can go to any levels of exploitation without undergoing right scrutiny.
In news from Afghanistan, Leadership Committee of the High Council for National Reconciliation in Afghanistan over the past weekend discussed the US proposed draft for Afghanistan's peace and the upcoming international conference on the reconciliation process in Turkey and Russia. The leaders have agreed that the Afghan Republic should thoroughly review the proposed draft for peace and then share it with the United States.
Afghan leaders over the past weekend under the Leadership Committee of the High Council for National Reconciliation discussed the US proposed draft for Afghanistan's peace and the upcoming international conferences on the reconciliation process in Turkey and Russia. The leaders have agreed that the Afghan Republic should thoroughly review the proposed draft for peace and then share it with the United States. The draft states that when the term of the proposed transition government ends, the future leader of Afghanistan will be elected through a popular vote. Meanwhile, Taliban spokesperson Mohammad Naeem, in a tweet, has said the draft they received a few days ago is still under consideration. This comes at a time when two separate US and Russian-backed peace conferences are scheduled to be held in the coming weeks. The Russian-backed conference is scheduled for March 18, while the US-sponsored one will take place in Turkey next month.
Moving on to news from Sri Lanka. Sri Lanka will ban the wearing of the burqa and shut more than 1,000 Islamic schools, the country's Minister for Public Security, Sarat Weerasekara, has informed. The latest policy decision affecting the minority Muslim population requires the approval of the cabinet and parliament before it becomes a law.
Sri Lanka will ban the wearing of the burqa and shut more than 1,000 Islamic schools, Sarat Weerasekara, the country's Minister for Public Security, said this weekend, the latest actions affecting the country's minority Muslim population. Weerasekara told a news conference he had signed a paper on Friday for cabinet approval to ban the full face covering worn by some Muslim women on national security grounds. He also said the government plans to ban more than 1,000 madrasa Islamic schools that he said were flouting national education policy.
ये मामा असम कला बुरका वा तहनाम करना ये नियोगी ये कैबिनेट पत्रिका वर इन बुरका वा क्यों हुआ एक अत अपे जाति का रक्षा वटर रुझो पलक पान दिया लेकिन तभी दान ना अपे पुंछ काले तभी ओन तरह अपे मुस्लिम यारो हिटिया मुस्लिम ज्ञान दरो हिटिया අදවකට මේ බුල්කාව පෙරදිගෙන හිටියේ නැහැ. ඒක මේ ඊයේ පෙරේද ආපු ආගමික අන්තවාදී සංකේතයක්. ඒක නිසා ඒක අපි අනිවාර්යයෙන්ම තහනම් කරනවා. ඒ වගේම තමයි මද්රසා පාසල් තියෙනවා 2000කට වඩා අපේ රටේ.
The latest move follows an order last year mandating the cremation of COVID-19 victims against the wishes of Muslims who bury their dead. This ban was lifted earlier this year after criticism from international rights groups. The wearing of the burqa in the majority Buddhist nation was earlier temporarily banned in 2019 after the bombing of churches and hotels by Islamic militants that killed more than 250 people.
In news from Nepal, as the world's tallest peak reopens after a year of being closed due to the coronavirus pandemic, hundreds of climbers are set to return to the Mount Everest for the first time next month under strict conditions.
Hundreds of climbers are set to return to Mount Everest for the first time next month under strict conditions, government officials and mountaineers said, as the world's tallest peak reopens after a year closed due to the coronavirus pandemic. More than 300 foreign climbers were likely to attempt to scale the 8,849-meter or 29,031-feet mountain in the peak climbing season beginning in April, compared with a record 381 climbers who attempted the famed summit in the same period in 2019. Eight of the world's 14 highest mountains, including Everest, are wholly or partially in Nepal, and hundreds of foreign climbers contribute millions of dollars in income annually to the cash-strapped nation.
हाम्रो बाटो त सबै त्यही हो क्लाइम्बरहरू अब सबै रेनी छ तर पनि अझै पनि हामीबाट चाहिँ सेफ्टी चाहिँ छैन हाम्रो जुन आरोहीहरूलाई पाउनु पर्ने अब यो भ्याक्सिनहरू पाएको छैन अब त्यही समस्या छ. अब भ्याक्सिन नलाइकन अहिले आरओहरूको कुनै दुई तिनवटा कम्पनीको त स्टाफहरू पनि तपाईँको बेस क्याम्प गइसकेको छ, बेस क्याम्प तयारी पार्नुको लागि.
नेपाल क्लोज इट्स माउन्टेन्स इन मार्च लास्ट इयर एज पार्ट अफ टाइट मेजर्स टु कन्ट्रोल द कोरोना भाइरस.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now, our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/asianewsline and follow us on Twitter at @asianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button. Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.